Let's look at apples coming out of dormancy, and it's exciting, of course. And usually you get bud swell, and we're going to look at bud swell. And again, there are two types of buds on apples, vegetative buds, that bud will swell and issue forth a leaf, and fruit buds. Fruit buds are more complex. They're called compound buds. They have a cluster of flowers with apples, usually 2 to 6 flowers, and a subtending circle of leaves, which are critically important because early in the season, that's where the source of photosynthesis as a source develops sugars that shuttles right to the developing fruit and helps it enlarge early in the season. And additionally, that compound bud has a vegetative shoot. So a compound bud in an apple or a pear has a cluster of flowers, subtending leaves. They're smaller than the branch leaves, and a little growth shoot. That's the deal. So let's take a look. Here we have a swelling bud, a fruit bud. Again, it's fat, it's round, it's a little bit furry. How cool is that? And it sticks out protrudes out from the stem a little bit. Let's move down the line a little bit. We have a bud that's a little further along. It has expressed and opened, and this is a vegetative bud. It's just going to have leaves, but leaves are good. And if we move down further to this bud, this is the further development of this vegetative bud. It's fully open, and it's got just a little bit of a growth terminus here. This will extend the branch. This will potentially be a nice lateral, moderate in length, relatively flat, and fruitful in a year or two. Let's move on down the line and look at this thing here, this amalgam. This is an expressed fruit bud. It's a young one on a young tree. This is a 3-year-old tree. As trees mature, their buds get bigger and they have more flowers and bigger flowers. But at this point, this one has 1, 2, and 3 flowers. All you need is for one to get pollinated and you've got yourself fruit. So that's the central point. And then these are the subtending leaves I was referring to. They're smaller than the branch leaves, but they photosynthesize and they shuttle sugars right away and over a short distance to these fruit, and their effectiveness is critical in developing fruit size in the first 30 days. And pretty much your fruit size for the season will be determined by the first 30 days of growth. So you want to giddy up and go. You want these leaves to be healthy, and they are in this instance. And then the third component of a compound bud in an apple is this little growth terminus here, or growth shoot. This will grow out, but not feet, maybe not even inches, maybe only millimeters, maybe inches, and be a nice flat, weak fruiting shoot with further fruit buds on it. So look at this section of this branch on this beautiful Mutsu apple. Mutsu is an exquisite apple. It's a large apple, good for eating out of hand. Actually, it's so big, eating out of two hands. We sometimes have 1-pounders. It is a sweet apple with good balancing acidity. It's never caught on in this country. It's a Japanese bred apple, Mutsu. And the reason it hasn't caught on is because it ain't red. People buy with their eyes. They buy red. They don't like green. Get Mutsu, grow it, eat it. Again, good eating out of hand, good for making pies, good for sweet cider. And here we are. This branch, this tree has come out of dormancy. It has stages of bloom, leafing out, and shoot extension. Let's look at these, let's break them down, look at them individually. If you can see in here, a little pruning cut was made last winter to stimulate growth. And this is the response. Early, a few weeks into the season already, we have 3-4 inches of extension growth. So this will grow out, mature, and in a couple, 3 years, that extension will look a lot like this section, which is a 2-3-year-old section of branch, decked out, as it were, with a bunch of different apple clusters. Again, apples bloom in clusters. They have compound buds. Let's look at this one. It's a little later than the rest. It's at what's called pink bud stage. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fruits here, or potential fruits here, now flowers, and we'll see what develops in terms of pollination. If we look at these other clusters here, they're at pretty much what would be called full petal, and shortly they'll hopefully get pollinated, set fruit, and simultaneously the petals will be dropping, and it will have to come in here in 3 or 4 weeks after that and thin to one apple here, one apple there, and one apple there. Again, keep in mind this is a big apple, so that's good. Let's just cross over here a little bit and look at a set of blooms that have gone by petal drop, and you can see the emerging fruit. Again, just petal starting to discolor, about to drop. We're at petal drop, fruit set here. Again, as I mentioned, I'll just come when we get the petal drop. I just go around the orchard anxiously wondering what the set is, and I'll just flick out the fruits and see how many remain. If they have formed but haven't been fully fertilized, they'll just drop off. So that's good news and bad news. It's good news because we have 100% set. The bad news is there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 fruit where you can only have one. We'll have to thin. We'll wait until it gets thumbnail size, thin down to one. Let's look at this cluster and see what the potential fruit set is. So I'm flicking, and oh, that one dropped off. Hey, so still a pretty heavy set. We'll have to thin. Here's a nubbin fruit cluster, and it looks different than the others we just looked at. It's just not as vibrant. The stems that hold the apple are not as long, and I suspect maybe not as good a fruit set, or maybe no fruit set. Let's see. Nada. So, not to worry, in the adjacent area we have plenty of other fruits that have set, but it's just a good way to know what your potential set is and how you have to mobilize. As I said, if you have a heavy set, you thin early and aggressively, and if it's less or even moderate set, you can employ 5 letters, R-E-L-A-X. You can just thin a little, get to it, it'll be fine. Okay, I'm standing here next to an apple tree, a 49-year-old apple tree on a semi-dwarfing rootstock. It is the variety Jonagold, and it is on the rootstock M106, which 49 years ago was considered a dwarfing rootstock. Now it's a semi-dwarfing rootstock. But still, we have a nice, tidy 12 to 15 foot tree, kept 12 to 15 foot by our pruning and training efforts. And here we are on the last day of April, a little late this season, but hey, that's the way nature rolls. Been a cool winter and spring. And this tree is in full bloom, and it's a thing of beauty, awesome beauty, I might add. Let's talk a little bit about the nature of the flower fruit buds on pome fruits, that's P-O-M-E, being principally apples and pears, in this case an apple. And that is, they are compound buds. There's a cluster of flowers, usually 2 to 6, and then inside that there's a little growth axis, a little shoot. So this will flower and hopefully fruit this year and grow millimeters and make some more flowers and keep on trucking down the road that way for about 8-10 years. Apple and pear blossoms are, again, a cluster, usually 2 to 6 individual flowers. Let's look at one here. Let's look at this one here. Here in the center, we have a big fat bloom. This is at what's called pink bud stage. Probably in a day or two, with temperatures in the 60s or 70s, it'll be at full bloom. In a day or three after that, it'll be at petal drop and hopefully pollinated and fertilized. But what we have here is a central bloom. It's bigger than the surrounding ones as a rule, and it's often referred to as the king bloom. And then there are anywhere from 2 to 6 satellite blooms in a circle around it. The king bloom is the biggest. It's the most attractive to pollinators. It has the most pollen. And if it gets pollinated and fertilized, it will have the biggest apple. So that's your hope here. And let's look at another one here. Let's look at this one. This is just, as I said, a few days down the road. You see, going from pink bud to slightly open. And then if we were to progress even further, we have the quintessential compound bud of an apple. Center king bloom and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 satellite blooms. Now, you can't carry but one fruit here, but having a lot of blooms ensures you a greater possibility of pollination and fruit set. Once this has set, we can take a look at thinning, but you would have to hand thin all but one fruit here. The other thing about apple blossoms is they're oh so sweet. And I can't say that, and I shouldn't say that, and I would never say that about a pear blossom. Pear blossoms smell like rotting meat. They're beautiful, but they smell like rotting meat. What's up with that? My theory is bees are not attracted to pear blossoms as they are to apple, plum, peach, etc. And so the smell, the fetid smell, is to attract flies. And largely I think that pears are pollinated by flies, but also by some parasitic wasps.